Floating floor installation tips. Every Cali bamboo floor can be floated, meaning it's installed without being attached to the subfloor. This is a very popular option because floating installations are generally faster, less expensive, and very DIY friendly. It's important to point out that unlike a nail or glue down installation, floated floors act as one entire unit because each plank is linked to its neighbor and not secured to the subfloor. And that's why including the right expansion space and T-molds are essential for a successful project. Here's why. According to the National Wood Flooring Association, like all hardwoods, bamboo and eucalyptus are hygroscopic. That means they expand with any increase in moisture and contract with any decrease. And this happens naturally with the changing of the seasons. When this fluctuation occurs with a floated floor, the tiny changes within each board compound across the entire run. Expansion occurs outwards from the center of the room towards the perimeter. Contraction occurs inwards towards the center and away from the perimeter. This is why Cali bamboo requires a half inch of expansion space between the flooring and all vertical objects. If your installation exceeds 30 feet, more expansion space is required, approximately 1/16 of an inch for every additional 10 feet. How much expansion space you include depends not only on the size of your installation, but also on expected seasonal changes. For example, if you install when humidity conditions are low, it's likely that the wood flooring will gain moisture and expand later on during more humid seasons. In this case, you should use additional expansion space with the help of spacers or transition moldings. Remember that expansion space is needed not just around the room's perimeter, but along the base of every unmoving vertical object, like cabinets, pipes, columns, fireplaces, and vents. For example, if a floated floor is cut too tightly around an air vent register and the floor expands with seasonal change, the planks around the vent will push against the register and force the floor upwards into a buckle. Similarly, if the floor contracts and begins moving toward the center of the room, the planks along the outside of the register next to the wall will have no room to move inward with the rest of the installation, and they will eventually separate. This may all sound kind of dramatic, but believe it or not, we want this free-floating movement of the floor, and it's important with a floated installation not to secure any one plank down to the subfloor. Imagine 100 planks are glued or nailed down in a square room, and each plank shrinks 1/100th of an inch, creating 1 inch of overall contraction. Well, since the entire floor is secured to the subfloor, there would only be a 1/100th of an inch gap between each plank, which is basically impossible to see. However, when the floor is floating and each plank shrinks 1/100th of an inch, the total shrinkage is still 1 inch, but instead of being spread across the entire floor, it's seen just along the edge. Now, picture a floating floor where the plank along the perimeter is pinned down to the subfloor, and each plank shrinks 1/100th of an inch. In this case, the entire floor is going to shrink towards that pinned down plank, creating a 1 inch gap on the opposite side of the room. It's not that the floor is actually shrinking more, it's just more noticeable because that one plank is held in place. By ensuring no planks are pinned down, the total expansion or contraction will be distributed evenly on either side of the room. That's why, for floating floors, we require that no cabinets or other permanent fixtures are installed on top of the floor, and nothing is ever nailed or screwed through the planks. You'll also want to steer clear of furniture over 500 pounds sitting on a floating floor. T-molds serve a very important role in floated installations, ensuring the floor has proper expansion space. According to installation instructions, floated floors specifically require T-molds to be installed in every doorway, archway, hallway, and opening between rooms when measuring 5 feet in width or less. When two or more rooms are installed as a floated floor, each area will expand and contract in relation to their own respective centers. When a T-mold is not installed to separate those two areas, pressure points will develop where the different areas meet. Expansion will cause planks to push against one another and risk buckling. Contraction will cause the floor to pull away towards conflicting centers and risk separation. Installing T-molds between different spaces allows for the proper expansion space to be maintained, so that the rooms can expand and contract independently. For more installation tips, contact Cali Bamboo's customer service team at customerservice@calibamboo.com or call 858-200-9540.